Hello, my name is Alex Isles and welcome to Howick on the Northumberland coast here in the northeast of England. And the reason I've come here today is because nearby to the location where I'm standing, one of the oldest buildings in the British Isles was discovered. It's been dated to 7,700 BC, so nearly 9,000 to 10,000 years ago, and it was occupied for around about 100 years. It's called the Howick House, and when it was first discovered, the journalists and newspapers had an absolute field day declaring that this was the oldest house in the British Isles. Since then, older buildings have been discovered. So for instance, Starcar in Yorkshire has had a ritual site discovered there, which also had a building on that location as well. Whether or not that was for ritual purposes or it was an actual settlement is another matter entirely. But what we have here is we have an actual example of a Mesolithic hut. Now this would have been quite important during its time because this would have been a location for a small group of hunter-gatherers to actually take advantage of the local land and also of the local resources around here. Now when I look out in this direction you can see the North Sea going out to the east of where I'm standing. And when you have the North Sea here, the original coast would have actually been about 300, maybe 400 meters further out. So because of this, this would have been a wonderful area where you'd be directly above a little river valley, which still exists today. So just over where you can see the trees in the distance over there, there would have been a river valley and the river would have gone into the North Sea, which existed back then. And then there would have been coastal plains that would eventually allowed for the Mesolithic hunter-gatherers to walk all the way across to the modern day Netherlands and across to mainland Europe. And that's originally how they arrived up here on the coast of Howick. They had come across from roughly where Denmark is today and migrated across the old North Sea basin, what is today we call Doggerland, and then had arrived up here on the coast. When they'd arrived here, they built this house, and the house, when it was reconstructed after the archaeologists excavated this location, was discovered to be quite large. It had a diameter of roughly about 5 to 6 meters. And when you've got this diameter of 5 to 6 meters, what they reckon is there's over two ways of its construction. The Mesolithic people, they had scraped out the bottom at the underneath the house. So there was a scraped bottom, which allowed for a small sort of circular, sort of semicircular dip in the land. And then around the outside, they had built upright beams of wood in the ground around the outside of the structure. And then when they put the uprights in, they then connected them together with cross beams that would bring it together and provide structural integrity. It was in a teepee shape, so it was triangular coming up, and then they surrounded the outside with reeds to provide waterproofing, and then covered the reeds with layers of turf so that it would be insulated as well and fire retardant. And so that's the way they constructed it, and they think that's one of the ways that possibly the Mesolithic people would have constructed it as well. In the site across in Mailman, at the Mailman Trail, what they did is they actually constructed it with a more domed roof. So it would have been domed with the reeds on the inside layer, the turf on the outside, and the uprights coming over in a more circular shape, almost like a dish shape. So it would have had an almost an upside down dish shape with a scrape layer underneath where they would have scraped out the earth and piled it around the insides, creating a very warm, very insulated, very private space on the inside for the Mesolithic people to live in. Both are equally valid. The teepee shape took a lot of inspiration from the North American populations and the First Nations across there, whereas the other shape has a lot more to do with the sort of yurts that you see in Central Asia and the shape of those sort of settlements as well. Unfortunately though, what had happened was a group of local children had got inside this reconstructed hut here on this site when the archaeologists reconstructed it, and they set it on fire. And when they set it on fire, it burnt to the ground. And so you can only see, if you look in the ground in front of me, a circular outline where the plants are growing slightly higher than the rest. And that is the outline of where this hut was. So when you've got this site here on in the northeast of England, the original Mesolithic hunter-gatherers would have had a hugely varied diet. They would have been able to go down to the sea area and they would have been able to get fish. And we can see a lot of their diet was fish. alongside that as well, they could have gone along the cliffs here, and they also ate seabirds. So seabirds have also been found. Like the rest of the hunter-gatherer population as well, at this time when Britain was getting warmer, there was a huge amount of hazelnut trees that had actually grown all around here, and a huge amount of their diet was actually hazelnuts as well. And then they also seem to have eaten other animals like seals, and inside the hut they also discovered the bones of a fox, a dog, or a wolf. It's one of those three, so it could either be one of their domesticated dogs they had, or they were maybe eating foxes, or possibly even it's an animal that they'd killed maybe for its hides or things like that, like a wolf. So you've got a combination of those inside the hut as well, which shows that they had a very varied diet. The family group that lived on this location lived here for nearly 100 years, so you can see quite a substantial amount. And back then they reckon the average life expectancy was only about 30 years. So because of that, you can see that there are numerous generations coming back to this site and living here before that maybe they eventually abandoned it and moved to another location nearby. But this group here was a part of a Mesolithic population of fishermen who had come across the North Sea, and in a later video I'm going to be talking more about them in depth and about what they, where they came from and their story as well as they came here, because it seems that there are two different Mesolithic groups in Britain during the Mesolithic period. So I really hope you've enjoyed this video today, that you've been able to learn something about the Mesolithic and the structure here that was on this site. And if you have, please do like and subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. Share the videos with your friends. And alongside that as well, please do, if you would like to, support me on Patreon, because then you get actually an opportunity to actually shape the where the channel's going by suggesting content and videos that you would like to see. In the meantime though, stay safe and well, and thank you so much